Good evening, and welcome to Ursuline Academy's Memorial Mass. I'm Peggy Slater, president of Ursuline, and it's my pleasure to welcome all the alumni, students, parents, co-workers, family, and friends who are joining us to honor their loved ones who have passed away this past year. Our Book of Remembrance, holding the names of those we remember and honor today, and votive candles have been placed on the altar to remember their lives and their legacy. May their spirit and light continue to be lived out in those who love them. And know that your loved ones are remembered throughout the year when we gather to pray. We welcome our celebrant, Father Bill Kempf from St. Justin Martyr, and our entrance song is Gathering Sin.
Stand and join in singing our gathering song together.
Everlasting life. who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Let me now sing of my friend, my friend's song concerning
doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
Found my grace. You can hear the blues in that voice.
I think many of you felt the sting of that same disappointment in our lives. Songs sung and blue about your child, the recipient of your heart and your love, and yet rewarded your loving sometimes with a lifetime of rebellion. Songs sung and blue about the company that rewarded your 20 years of faithful work with a furlough or a pink slip. Songs sung and blue about lost love on the pavement of an affair. Songs sung and blue about the church that betrayed you. Songs sung and blue about a global pandemic that's changed just about everything in life. There are thousands of blues that we can sing, aren't there? So how does God respond to our blues? How did God respond to the abject failure of his vineyard? You might expect that God will do nothing, that perfect love means that we let people walk over us. Others might expect that God's going to zap that field. He's going to torch the whole thing, and it's just all going to go away. But God does respond, make no mistake about it. And his response is his judgment. And it is both measured and merciful. And here is God's judgment on that vineyard and the vines. He gave the vine their wish. He left the vine alone. It didn't want to produce. It's really a terrifying picture of wrath, isn't it? God just lets the vine go. And when God withdraws, honoring that flagrant and rebellious demand of his creation, don't the weeds and the insects retake the garden? Don't they, you know, which turns the paradise of God's care into a chaos kind of our own making? Really ask any farmer, any gardener. We had some lovely raised gardens in the back of our school back in March, well attended to, and then everything shut down and nobody touched them all summer long. And I can tell you, we filled two dumpsters full of weeds just from these raised gardens. The only thing you have to do to ensure that the failure of a crop is not show up in nature and do the rest. That's what God does when he promises, when he gives, when he gifts to that vineyard who refuses to produce fruit. Well, I'll just let you go there. But know this about God's announcement, and not just here, but in other places. Aren't they really spoken as like his song sung blue, his last desperate effort in the hope that they'll never come to pass, but that they will break loose something in our hearts, and we will know, we'll realize that love that God has for, and it'll wake us up before tragedy takes place, so that it will never befall us. Then here is the wonderful truth about God and the story of the vineyard, because we see that Jesus takes it up. God never stops loving us, never ceases to try to find a way to bring forth the best of wine, even if it will cost him everything. So Jesus is born among us. And he takes up that famous blues ballad in the Gospels, because he wanted the people of his time to know that God had not given up on them. That God himself in him was still singing his love song, still offering grace, still intent upon sharing his vintage with the whole of creation. And isn't that the invitation of every Eucharist that you and I are privileged to partake in? That Jesus gives yearning gives flesh to the yearning of God. Said, what more was there for me to do for my vineyard? And we know the answer, I will give myself for it. My flesh, my blood will become life-giving food, life-giving drink for all. I will empty my love and my life for that vineyard, so that they would come to know that yearning in my heart, they would come to know my desire, that each and every lost and lonely would know a grace and a mercy that sets them free. And each time you and I celebrate,
around us. We know the truth of God's offer of love for us. And each time that we are together in spirit, our song, our prayer, our participation, isn't it our response in a small way to God? That we're not going to be about unrequited love, that we are trying to break forth the vineyard, the produce in our own hearts, and not that our own hearts be bare, but rather despite and in the midst of this trials and struggles and blues of our life, that somehow we say, Lord, you matter. Your people matter, your kingdom matter, and therefore I would love you with all that I have because you have loved me with your Son. So, whether you're singing the blues for yourself these days, or remembering in this celebration all those who are not in our midst, whether because of the pandemic and they couldn't be in this physical space, or death, or even like Isaiah, singing of a friend's love for his vineyard, know that it is never, that grief, that sadness, those blues are never the final stanza in the song. The final stanza of every blues song is sung by God's Son upon the cross. A song of sacrificial love. Sung so that we might know whatever we've done, however long life has sung for us, however we've made a mess of God's gift and God's life to us. God has come to us upon the cross. God comes to us upon this altar to bring us to Him. We stand as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified and in Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who hath spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess to the baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, life of the world to come. Amen. And so as a people of faith, we turn now to the Lord, asking for what we need so that our lives might indeed bear fruit for the kingdom.
From conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our cities and neighborhoods, that God will help us recognize the systemic injustices that exist within our communities and give us the courage to work for change and reconciliation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering from the aftermath of hurricanes and wildfires, that God will protect them from further harm, help them to connect with family and friends, and fill their hearts with courage, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With gratitude for our alumni and for everyone in the Ursuline family, both locally and globally, that with God's grace and through the intercession of St. Angela, that we may remain together in heart and live out our gospel call of Serbia, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those who have died, especially those we remember today, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, look upon this family gathered here before you, those also watching at home. Hear the prayers we have brought to you, the ones that are still in the quiet of our hearts. We continue to sing your song of love to us, that we might respond with all that we are. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you.
exaltation we acclaim. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Savior's command and form.
lead. May we always free from sin and safe from all distresses. We wait with blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Offer each other a bow and gesture of waving of peace.
You take the pain, the sins of the world, and
Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume. In Christ our Lord.
Thank you for the invitation to be with you. Over my prayers for you, this community, those here and those at home on these days. Is there an announcement today?
Yes. At the conclusion of this Mass, the president of the Ursuline Alumni Association has a brief message to share with our community.
The Lord be with you.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorify the Lord with your lives.
Thank you for joining us as we celebrate and remember the Ursuline community's loved ones today. While this day feels a little different than it has in the past, we are grateful to be here together in spirit and together in heart celebrating the Ursuline community. We also have an extra special reason to celebrate this year as we honor Thelma Hartnett's 100th birthday and our gratitude for Thelma's 55 years of service to Ursuline. On behalf of the Alumni Association, we invite all alumni, regardless of where you are across the world or when you graduated, to celebrate Ursuline this week. Though we are miles apart, we are together in heart.